You may not be aware of it, but there is a war going on in this country. It is being fought in the streets of one of our biggest cities. People are dying in record numbers. Ron Allen takes you to the battlefront in tonight's Eye on America.
It's a revolutionary war now in Los Angeles.
These are all my brothers.
These are not pit bulls. They're not. They're kids.
I lost a sister and a brother on the same night.
Gang violence in Los Angeles. More than a dozen dead every week. Neighborhood battles about drugs, turf, loyalty among 100,000 Crips and Bloods.
To the outside, untrained eye, it looks like just chaos, crazy. But to us, we know how we got to this point. The death of a brother is enough to motivate to kill.
Bone is a Blood, a general in the war. Many with his status are jailed or dead.
And Babyface was shot with an AK in the car.
The graffiti tracks the vicious cycle of murder and retaliation. Bone insists that's the only way to settle these decade-long feuds.
How many of them have you gotten revenge for?
All of them.
They say everybody up there has been avenged. You gotta understand, the system doesn't work for us. When one of our people dies, police don't give a damn, you know? They make the report, scoop the body up, and he's gone to the morgue. They like, yeah, one less nigga off the street.
He got shot right here on this corner.
Lorna Hawkins' 21-year-old son, Joe, was an innocent bystander. About one of every four gang shootings claims someone like him.
It's a lot of nonsense just to do what the hell they want to do, which is kill. And terrorize the streets. The ones that killed my son, I could rip their heart out right now.
Hawkins started a cable TV show that encourages other mothers to vent their anger.
Let's hear from the call. I'm sorry.
She hopes community outrage will someday stop the killings.
People should be concerned about drive-by shootings and about gangs because this is, they live with us. They live on our streets. They live in our houses.
And the violence is spreading to more neighborhoods. The number of gang-related killings in Los Angeles is expected to break a record for the fifth straight year. Some say the average life expectancy for any gang member is just 19.
This is our future. If you care about your future, you better care about these kids.
When author Leon Bing tried to understand LA's gangs, she found teenagers so alienated and frustrated by their surroundings that life had little value.
And if they are vicious killers, if they are aberrations of society, this is our society, and we have to look to ourselves. How'd they get that way?
If there's any hope of saving the next generation from the ritual of retaliation, former football star Jim Brown may have an answer.
Damn, I'm glad you made it.
Bone and other legendary Bloods and Crips now meet regularly at Brown's home.
We have some of the most volatile individuals in this city in this room right now.
The sessions are like group therapy. Brown's AmeriCan program seeks to focus their energy in a more positive direction.
So we are a political force, a social force, an economic force. To do right.
The message might break through to men like Bone, who are now fathers. He doesn't want the next generation growing up as he did, constantly worrying about the next bullet.
I got faith in my heart and I believe it's going to stop. It might not be in our lifetime. It might not be in none of our lifetimes. You know, as long as it stops.
Ron Allen, CBS News, Los Angeles.